Hey guys, it's Felix Sam here. In this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you how to build your very own language translation app. We are going to be building this using the Python programming language and the Streamlit library. If you are a beginner, don't worry, we'll start everything from scratch so you'll be able to follow and also understand in order to build your own language translation app. If you are much excited about this, let's get started and build this app. So I'll be using Visual Studio Code in this tutorial, so you can also use any editor of your choice, but make sure you follow the exact steps we'll be doing in this particular tutorial. To start off, you have to install the libraries we'll be using. So I have the requirement.txt file here, and as usual, this code will be on GitHub, so you can leverage it and use it in your own application. So we have to install Google Translate. And make sure you install this exact version because I had problem with other versions before. So now open your terminal and just write pip install, that should be lowercase, pip install, and then you just copy this same version and make sure you paste it here, then you click enter. So this will go ahead and install the library for you. I've already installed it, so you can see I have requirements already satisfied. And you have to go ahead and do the same for the Streamlit library as well. So still write pip install and do the same thing for the Streamlit library. So I also copy it here and paste it here as well. Click enter and I'll get the same thing because I've installed it. So for you guys, it will go ahead and install it for you. So you must make sure you have internet connection. So we are just done with the installation process, so now we'll go ahead and create a Python file where we are going to code this app. Okay, so to start off, I also have language.py. So this contains the language, all the languages we'll be translating. So you can see it's just a number Python list. I don't want it to be in the main code because it's a long list, so I want to keep everything clean. So I just created languages. That's languages.py, which will be importing into our main file. So let's go ahead and create a main file. I'll call this app.py. I click enter. So in app.py, now you have to import the libraries we've installed. So I'll say from Googletrans, I'm importing translator, which we'll be using, and that's it. Let's also import this our languages.py so that we can utilize our languages. So from languages, we are going to import everything. So to import everything, you just add asterisk and that's it. So you are importing everything in that particular file. And then the last thing we import is the Streamlit library. We import Streamlit as st, and that's all. So we are just done with importing the library. So now I want to teach you how easy you can translate between any two languages before we integrate this with our app. So for that, you have to create a translator object. So we call this translator, and this is equal to translator, which we've imported, and that's it. So now let's say we want to translate from English to Spanish. What we will do here is that we'll see our translator.translate, and in here we specify the text we want to translate. So we want to translate from English. So let's say we want to say hello, and then we want to translate this to Spanish. So we have to specify the destination language, which is simplified here, DEST, dest, and then you have to write it here. So in this case, we are going to translate to Spanish. So we just have to type Spanish over here. And then let's assign this to out. Yeah, out will be good. So we can go ahead and print out to see our translated word. Okay, so let me run this. Pull up the terminal. And here we go. So you can see we have it here translated. The source is English. So let me raise this up. The destination is Spanish. I don't know if they represent it with ES, and the test is hola. So hola, like hello in English means hola in Spanish. So that's correct, though I can't speak Spanish, but I know this is one common term they're using, hola, hola. So that's it. In case you only need the text, you just do out.txt so that we only get the output text, which is important to us. So I click on it again to run it, and now we are expecting only hola and not any other things, the source and the destination. Really want the text, and here we go. So you can see really. So this is how easy you can translate between any languages using this particular Google library. Now that we are able to do this, let's integrate this to into our app. So for that, I'll comment this whole code, and then we'll start off by building our app. So for that, let's start with the title. So st.title. So we are using Streamlit in this case, and we will call this a language translation app. So we created a title for our app, and we are going to call this language translation app. And the next thing we have to also create is a text input where you can enter any text you want to translate. We'll call this source text. That's good. So let's call it source text, and this will be equal to st, which is Streamlit.text input, because we need a text input where we can input our text. So since it's an app, I'll prompt you to enter the text you want to translate, and that's it. So we can even run this to see how our app will look like. So to run this, let me first clear the terminal, and all you have to type is Streamlit run and app.py. So Streamlit run, then the name of your Python file. So our name is app.py, so you just have to type it in and hit enter. So this will go ahead and run it for you. Open your web browser if possible. So you can see this is the exact interface we've designed. We've given it a title, language translation app, and now we have given it a text input. Okay, so the next thing you have to do now is to bring a select box here, in which we can just select the particular language you want to translate into. That's the destination language. So we'll come down here, and then we have to type our target language. So our target language will be equal to st.selectbox. So we forgot to put equal sign here. And in this select box, first you have to give it a label. So we'll tell the user to select the target language. So I'll just type that in. And the next thing you have to provide here is the languages. So now we have to provide the list of all these languages we have here into it. So we'll store that into options. So we call it options. And options here will be equal to a list. So our options here will be equal to languages, because we are importing languages here. So just set it to languages, and that's all. Okay, so you click save. And one thing I like about Streamlit is that once you are writing the code, it's updating to whatever you are doing. So let's open and check it out. We'll click on always rerun, and you can see. So if I click the select box here, you can see we have all our languages here. So what we'll do now is to go ahead and translate based on the language selected and the text we've input here. So let's create a translate button, which we'll just click so that we'll get the whole process running. So we'll call this button translate, and this will be equal to st.button. And inside this button, what we are going to type is translate, which will be the name of the button. Okay, so that's nice. So the spelling of the button here is wrong. You can see Streamlit has no attribute button, I don't know. So you have to spell it well. And that is it. So let's save it, and we can see this in action. So you can see we have the button here. So the thing is, whenever we click on this button, we'll get our text, whatever is in our text input, we'll get it, and we'll get the language selected, and then we'll translate. So that's what you are going to do. So what we'll do here is that if translate, that's if the translate button is being clicked, then we are going to do all our translation here. We'll create a translator object, then we'll do everything here. So we create a translator object, and then our text here will be equal to the text we are getting, that's the source text. So release hello here with the source text, and our destination here will also replace it with the target language. So that's how simple is it. And the output here will just display it on the app, not on our terminal, so that it will look nice. So I'll just replace print here with st.write, and that's it. So I'll save this, and then I'll return to our app, and that's it. So let's do our hello thing. Hello, and I want to translate hello to Spanish. Click on Spanish, and then I'll hit translate. So you can see hola, and that's it. So I'll say hello to all my followers. That's followers, and let's see. So hola, I can't really read. I can't really read in Spanish, but I know some of my followers, you are going to comment if it's right or not. Or better still, we can use the online translator to check it out. So this is in English. I'll just replace whatever we have here, and you can see it looks the same, kind of the same. Hello, something like that. So our app, this what so that does it. So we have just built a translation. So we have just built a language translation app. You can switch from different languages. Let me choose so Chinese simplify, and also see I can't read Chinese, but this is what hello to all my followers looks like in Chinese. So this is how easy it is to build your app. You can switch from different languages, and you can just use this as a portfolio project or something like that. So let me know, guys, what you'll be using this for, and also I'll be deploying this on the net, and the link will be in the video description where you can have access and use it yourself. But let me know if you want to learn how to deploy this on a Streamlit cloud, so that everyone can have access to and use it, because without deploying it, it's not useful and no one can use it. So let me know if you want to see a video on that. But I'll deploy it and put the link. But if you want to see a video, I'll just walk you through how to easily deploy it. It's very easy and it's useful as well. So guys, thanks for watching this tutorial. If you like it, give me a thumbs up. Also subscribe and share with somebody who might need this. Thanks for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next tutorial.